Hello everyone, welcome to Prajeem Technologies. My name is Deepika. This is part 1 of class 9th mathematics tutorial. In this session, we will discuss class 9th syllabus, marks assessment pattern and number system introduction. Let's get into details. When we look into the syllabus, it has divided into 6 units. Number system, algebra, coordinate geometry, geometry, mensuration, statistics and probability. Now, let's look into how marks are distributed between board exam and internal assessment. When we look into the marks distribution, board exam is for 80 marks, whereas internal assessment is for 20 marks. Again, these 20 marks are divided into 3 components, that is periodic test for 10 marks, notebook for 5 marks and subject enrichment is for 5 marks. In this session, we will start with first unit, that is number system. When we look into the syllabus of number system, it is divided into 4 chapters, that is review of numbers, non-recurring or non-terminating decimals, rationalization and loss of exponent. In this session, we will start with first chapter of number system, that is review of numbers. Let's see various ways of representation of numbers. Natural numbers. The number starts from 1, extends up to infinity are called natural numbers, and these numbers are represented with the letter N. And when you observe this, 0 is missing in this. So when 0 is included to the natural numbers, such type of numbers are known as whole numbers and represented with the letter W. Negative numbers along with whole numbers are known as integers. That means integers includes negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. And these numbers are represented with the letter Z. Next type of numbers are called rational numbers. These are in the form of P by Q. That is, fractions are known as rational numbers. So in this, the denominator value should not be equals to 0. That is, Q is not equals to 0. We can tell so many examples like 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 5 by 7. Even negative numbers like minus 3 by 4, minus 5 by 8, etc. Till now we have discussed various ways of representation of numbers. Let's see how these numbers can be represented on number line. So following examples will be discussed in detail, that is representation of numbers on number line and finding a rational number between given rational numbers. Let's see how we can solve these questions on board. You know that number line is nothing but it's a horizontal line where 0 is represented at the middle and all positive numbers are on the right hand side of 0, whereas all negative numbers will be represented on left hand side. So now the question is represent following numbers on number line. So to represent 2, so where is the 2? It will be on right hand side of 0. So just mark circle over there that indicates 2, or it indicates 2 units from 0. Now, how to represent minus 3 on number line? So it's a negative number, so it lies on left hand side of 0 and it will be 3 units from 0. Just mark a circle over minus 3. This indicates minus 3 on number line. It's a just recap, as we have already studied all this on class 8. The next question is representation of minus 4 by 3 on number line. Let's see where this number lies. So when we observe this fraction, we can say that this number lies between minus 1 and minus 2. And this denominator part indicates how many divisions has to be done in between two numbers. So if I take 0 and minus 1, let's take 3 equal parts. This is one part, this is second, and this indicates third part. Similarly, in between minus 1 and minus 2, this is one part and this is second part. So this indicates third part. Now write the numbers. So this part indicates minus 1 by 3. Now it's divided into 3 equal parts. Let's write the numbers. So this part is nothing but the first part. It indicates minus 1 by 3. So this is nothing but minus 2 by 3. This is minus 3 by 3. That is equals to minus 1. and this is minus 4 by 3. The question is, we have to represent minus 4 by 3 on number line. So just circle over here. This indicates representation of minus 4 by 3 on number line. The same rule can be applied even if it is a mixed fraction. Now let's see next question, that is representation of 5 by 3 on number line. As it is a positive number, so it will be on right hand side of 0, and its value lies between 1 and 2. So let's divide, as the denominator is 3, let's divide into 3 equal parts, 1 and 2. And similarly in between 1 and 2. So this is 1 by 3, 2 by 3, and this is 3 by 3, that is nothing but 1. This is a 4 by 3, this value is 5 by 3. So just circle over here, this is nothing but 5 by 3 on number line. Till now we have discussed how to represent numbers on number line. Let's see one more type of example where you have to find out a rational number between minus 3 and 1. So I'll write the solution here. Solution for question number 2. So what's given? You have to find a rational number between minus 3 and 1. So let me write as step 1. So to solve this, what I will do is, I'll take average of given two numbers. As you know, average is nothing but sum of the quantities divided by number of quantities. In this case, the numbers are minus 3 and 1. So just add it, that is minus 3 plus 1 divided by 2. So the result will be minus 2 divided by 2. So in step 2, I will write it as minus 2 by 2 is nothing but minus 1, or we can write in the form of rational number, that is minus 1 divided by 1. So any number which can be represented in the form of P by Q can be called as a rational number. So this minus 1 lies between minus 3 is less than minus 1 is less than 1. Now let's see question number 3, where you have to find it out a rational number between given two rational numbers, that is 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Let's follow the same steps, like finding the average of given two numbers, that is 3 by 5 plus 4 by 5 divided by 2. In step 2, I will add numerators directly as the denominator values are same. Then it will be 3 plus 4, 7 divided by 5 whole divided by 2. This can also be written as 7 by 5 into 2. So in step 3, I'll write it as 7 by 10, and this value lies between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. That is, 3 by 5 is less than 7 by 10 is less than 4 by 5. This is to find a rational number between given numbers. Let's see, if you had to calculate more than one rational number, that is, if you had to insert more than one rational number between given two numbers. Let's discuss in next example. Let's look into one more type of question. Question number 4, find 10 rational numbers between 2 by 7 and 5 by 7. Okay. So in previous example, we considered average of given two numbers. Let's do this question with another method, where this first fraction, that is 2 by 7, is multiplied and divided by 10. So now the resultant fraction is 20 divided by 70. Similarly, in step 2, I'll take second fraction, that is 5 by 7, multiplied with 10 divided by 10. So the resultant fraction is 50 by 70. So now we have to insert 10 rational numbers between 20 by 70 comma 50 by 70. We can do that, right? So it will be 21 by 70, 22 by 70, 23 by 70, 24 by 70, 25 by 70, 26 by 70, 27 by 70, 28 by 70, 29 by 70, comma 30 by 70. This is how we can calculate 10 rational numbers between 2 rational numbers. So from these examples, we can say that we can insert any number of rational numbers between given two rational numbers. Let's see question number 5, where you have to find out 6 rational numbers between minus 1 by 3 and 7 by 6. But for this question, we cannot apply the rule which we have applied for question number 4. As we know that the denominators are different in both the cases. So that's the reason what I will do is, I will convert the first fraction denominator as same as second denominator. So how can I do that? Minus 1 by 3, if I multiply this with 2 by 2. So then the resultant fraction is minus 2 by 6. Now we can insert 6 rational numbers between minus 2 by 6, comma 7 by 6. Let's see how we can do that. One is minus 1 by 6. Another one is 0 by 6, 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6 and so on. Even 6 by 6 also we can insert. Even though we required 6, but we can insert 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 rational numbers we can insert between these two. These are different methods to insert rational numbers between given two rational numbers. In next tutorial, we will be starting with second chapter of number system, that is non-terminating or non-recurring decimals, by explaining with simple and easy examples. Please feel free to provide your feedback or questions in comment section. Thank you for listening. Have a great day.